It's going to be like an ASMR abandoned sites, I guess, like famous abandoned sites. So this episode will be covering River Country, which is Disney's abandoned water park. So all sources and links will be in the description down below. So let's get right into it. So for those of you who are unfamiliar with what River Country was slash is, it was Walt Disney World's first water park, located along Bay Lake near the fort, right next to Fort Wilderness, the Fort Wilderness Hotel area. And so it was right next to Bay Lake, and it opened on June 20th, 1976. So it's pretty old. It featured a large swimming pool, water rapids, raft rides, rope swings, multiple water slides, including one that was up to 260 feet long, and a beach for guests to swim in. So the way it worked was, there was a swimming pool, and then the beach part, I don't remember, it was kind of like a cove in a way. So the beach part did use the Bay Lake water, so it was warm fresh water, and but it wasn't like the Bay Lake just came in right into this cove when Disney was like, okay, we're gonna use this park. What they did was they built a cove that was actually above where Bay Lake was. So Bay Lake's water level was here, there was like a wall, and the cove was like here. So but they would pump in the Bay Lake water from their for the water slides, so the water slides would empty into this into the cove area. So it would be, so in a way it's using the lake water, except it was filtered and all that. However, there are some alleged issues with that, which I will get into. But so in the 1990s, Disney actually banned swimming in the lakes, but they kept River Country open. So now you can't swim in Bay Lake, but you used to be able to. So River Country was open seasonally as opposed to year-round, meaning that there were some months it was open and some months it was not. And it closed just as expected on November 2nd, 2001, because it was the end of the season, and it was expected to reopen in, I think, April, but it never reopened. So allegedly, there was some news article that said that on April 11th, 2002, a news article came out and said that the park would never reopen, but Disney didn't officially announce that it was never going to open until 2005. So it's three years difference. They just didn't say anything about it. They were like, just closed for an extended period of time. They didn't say if it was ever going to reopen, but in 2005 they finally did announce that it was never going to reopen. They drained parts of it. They built a green fence around it to keep people out, and they just kind of left it there. And all the remains of the park and all that, the structures and the ruins, that they're all still there. Legally, you cannot visit that part of Disney World. Like, you cannot, there are urban explorers who try to do it, and some of them do succeed, but Disney will prosecute you if you do. It's trespassing, because even though as large as Disney World is, it is still considered private property, so it means they can still prosecute you for trespassing in certain areas, which they have, and they will do that. Basically, there are urban explorers who go out and explore the river country ruins without Disney's permission, and they'll take photos and all that, but then they'll post it onto YouTube, and then Disney will see it. Disney sees it, and then these people are basically banned from any Disney property for life, and Disney owns a lot. was very beloved by many people, and a lot of people were really surprised that when Disney said it was going to close. The first theory is the brain-eating virus. So, in bodies of warm, fresh water, there is something called an amoeba called Neuralia flowery, and it's an amoeba. And then there was a death of an 11-year-old boy in late August 1980 due to a disease caused by the amoeba called amoebic meningoencephalitis. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but amoebic meningoencephalitis, which basically it attacks the nervous system. So tragically, he died, and the cause was deemed because he swam in a body of warm, fresh water at Disney World's River Country. So River Country was basically named the place where he made contact with the amoeba and fell ill. However, Disney was found not at fault, since the amoeba can breed in any warm, fresh water in the summer and hot weather. So they were found to be not at fault. So one of the reasons, so a lot of people speculate that the one of the reasons why they closed it was because they didn't want to risk any more deaths related to amoebas found in the fresh water, which it's kind of far-fetched. It's really sad that the child died, but I don't think Disney closed one of their water parks solely for that reason. I mean, it could be one of the possibilities, but personally, I think it's another reason. Also, as I mentioned earlier, in the 1990s, Disney banned swimming in lakes in their parks, but they still kept River Country open. So basically, you used to be able to swim in Bay Lake, I guess, but you still can't. I think now they don't even let you go in the water. They put up a fence after an alligator attack. I was actually in Disney World, like, I think a week after the whole alligator attack thing happened. It was really sad. But, so you can't go in Disney's lakes anymore, but when they closed when they banned swimming in lakes, they still kept River Country open. So that kind of leads me to believe that the whole amoeba theory is wrong. But yeah, because of that, for that reason, that's why I believe that it was not the reason why Disney closed the River Country Park due to the amoebic lake water. So, another probably the more, like, theory that makes more sense is a whole financially feasible theory. Well, it's not really a theory, but I'm gonna call it a theory. So basically, the entire tourism industry kind of fell significantly after the tragic events of 9/11. Disney saw a significant decrease in the amount of people who were coming to their parks, and as a result, they saw a decrease in their revenue, which meant they had to make some cuts. So a lot of hotels that they had planned to open, as well as rides and other attractions, they were canceled or pushed off, but a lot of them were canceled. In fact, some of the hotels were later abandoned, like the Art of Animation Resort that was planned to be part of, Pop Century. I don't remember the one. I don't remember what it was called. I think it's Pop Century. But it was basically planned to be opened as part of that, but they closed it, and they it's originally a whole other themed park, but they pushed it off, and eventually they canceled it, and eventually they changed the whole theme and made it Power Animation. But anyway, that's right. A little detour there. So because of this, River Country, one of the reasons why people believe that River Country was closed was just that it was no longer financially the best option, as it was small. It was small in comparison to Blizzard Beach and Typhoon Lagoon, which were their newer water parks that opened in 1995 and 1989, respectively. So, Disney felt that those parks could also be more profitable. Like I said, I think this theory makes more sense, just because money seems to be a driving force with a lot of decisions like this. So, like I said, Disney basically just built a fence around the ruins, around the site, and just kind of left it there. So, nearly 17 years later, after it originally reported it was going to be closed, the buildings are still there. It's overgrown. The wildlife has claimed it back. So Disney filled in the swimming pool with sand to prevent mosquitoes from breeding in it and possibly risking the exposure to the Zika virus. This was back in 2016. Because they already had some bad press due to the alligator attack of that one child. So they didn't want to risk any more deaths at the park. So some other reasons why it may have closed was that it was small. Like I said, in comparison to Blizzard Beach and Typhoon Lagoon, as well as the location. So I read an article saying that because it was next to Fort Wilderness, and the people had to drive to park at Fort Wilderness, which I guess didn't have as great of a parking area or something, and then they had to walk all the way to River Country, and that was just something that a lot of people just didn't want to do. And with the openings of Blizzard Beach and Typhoon Lagoon, which are more accessible, it pushed more people to go to those parks instead of River Country. So as time progressed, River Country just slowly became less and less profitable. So as for River Country today, like I said, there's the ruins are still there. The towel holder things, the showers are currently being used as part of another part of Fort Wilderness, except they walled the shower part off, so it's just a regular bathroom. The slides, everything's still there, but it's in extremely deteriorating condition. I'll put some photos in. So it's in deteriorating condition. The wildlife has claimed it back. There's bramble and everything growing over trees and plants and all that. The marshes have taken it. It's taking back the land. However, in October 2018, Disney did announce that the site of River Country would be turned into a new resort for Disney Vacation Club members. So, Disney Vacation Club is their timeshare program that Disney has, and they have exclusive resorts such as Bay Lake Tower and the Contemporary Resort, and then at the Polynesian Resort, I'm pretty sure they have like those like little Polynesian villas or houses on Bay Lake. Those are also, I don't know what lake they're on, but those villas are also Disney Vacation Club property. So in order to go on those resorts, you have to be part of their timeshare program, I think. I mean, there's other ways you can stay at them, I believe, because when I first went to Disney World when I was really young, we stayed at Bay Lake Tower, but we're not Vacation Club members. I think we knew someone who was, though, or something like that. I don't know how it worked. But, so Disney did announce that they're going to be converting the River Country Water Park space into a Disney Vacation Club hotel spot. So, I think I saw some concept art. Maybe I'll plug that in here, too. But it'll be really interesting to see how it turns out. But I think it'll also be kind of sad because it's like the end. It's truly the end of an era for Disney. Like, there's for people who maybe hope that someday River Country would be fixed and reopened. It's very clear by this move that River Country will never reopen for good. Like, never. I think that's everything I have in my notes. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know in the comments. movies I should do next also count on that. I have a few. I want to do a few more Disney ones because Disney has a lot. Like I said,